They love hoops and horse racing in the Bluegrass State, but today they're taking it to the mats in Lexington, Kentucky. The Arkansas Gymbacks at Kentucky in the final home meet for the Wildcats. It's Gymbacks and Wildcats next on FSN. Historic Memorial Coliseum in Lexington, Kentucky, the site of so many great memories for the Kentucky Wildcat basketball team. Today, it's Arkansas and Kentucky, the Gymbacks and the Wildcats. Wildcat fans are ready for what could be an upset. They have never beaten the Arkansas Gymbacks. Welcome, everybody. I'm Corey Kessler, along with Lori Strong-Ballard. Both the Gymbacks and the Wildcats receiving some accolades from the audience this afternoon because it's Senior Day here in Memorial Coliseum. Our authority on the SEC gymnastics is here with more.
Thanks, Corey. Arkansas and Kentucky are two SEC rivals with very similar goals. Both are starting to gain momentum and hope to reach their ultimate goal of breaking into the top tier in the SEC and qualifying a full team to the national championships later this season. Kentucky hopes to feed off of their success from last year, where in his fourth year as head coach, Mo Mitchell led this team to their first winning season in 13 years, and he was honored as the Central Region Coach of the Year. In the second half of the season, Kentucky is working hard at gaining some consistency. Now, 2006 was a breakthrough year for Arkansas as well. And in the words of Coach Renee Cook, it was a fairy tale come true. Arkansas, in their fourth year of the program's existence, qualified a team to the national championships. And now, midway through this season, they're ranked 14th in the country and can build on that here, but they are looking for a very strong road score. Now, both the coaches and the athletes have their eye on a win, but tonight's goal for both these teams is consistency and a great score.
Well, it's very important. You know, we've had a few good road competitions, but we had a fairly poor performance at Utah due to a lot of unforeseen circumstances. We were just happy to get out of there without an injury. So tonight's important to us. You know, we need to hit our routines. We need to not count a fall. And if we can do that, we feel we should score fairly well, and that will help us in our overall ranking and our goals towards, you know, getting into the top 10, hopefully. So we're really focusing on that.
We have not hit a meet since the season started. I mean, it's either one event or another. And I think with some devoted athletes working hard, they want to put it together this meet. They've come down with a commitment that we're going to go 24 for 24.
In gymnastics, consistency and experience seem to so often go hand in hand. And luckily for these young teams, they have some senior leaders to lean on. For Arkansas, it's with Cassie Drew, one of their top all-arounders who recently won a floor title against powerhouse Alabama. And Kentucky's Crystal Cook will be competing in her senior night here at Memorial Coliseum. This is her last chance to compete in front of her home crowd. She's great in the all-around and recently has put up 2 9-9s on bars in the last several weeks. Back to you, Corey.
Well, we'll find out if Crystal Cook can lead her Wildcats past the visiting Gymbacks for the first time ever. A great gymnastics meet if you stay with us. Welcome back to Memorial Coliseum in Lexington, Kentucky for an SEC gymnastics meet. It is senior night here in Memorial Coliseum. Some of the Wildcats being honored, including Crystal Cook.
And Crystal will be celebrating her senior night tonight with three other seniors, but she is most definitely one of the leaders on this team and in that group, not only with her gymnastics, but Coach Mo Mitchell, who we just saw, says that she leads by example and hard work in the gym.
And how's the year been going for Crystal and the team? Let's listen.
It's been a little shaky. You know, we're on a gradual up. We didn't start off as high as we did last year, but we got a lot of talented freshmen and we have a lot of good returners, and I feel like we're about to start a new season. I mean, we're halfway. We're about to start counting all our home scores and everything with the RQS, and I think we have a really good chance to turn this whole season around and get people noticing that we're coming back and we're coming for them in the rankings.
And now that we're midway through the season, rankings are done by RQS, and that means the six top scores are taken. Three must be away. They drop the high, and they average the rest, and that gives you your rankings.
You see the Wildcat lineup on vault, and guess who's up first? Crystal Cook.
Again, they have a very young team, three freshmen competing for them, but now we see the senior looking for a strong start to her senior night tonight. Yuchenko half front layout, small hop on the landing, but I'd say that is a strong start. Kentucky's first vaulter took a crash, so now this team is feeling the pressure to hit, and this senior, Crystal Cook, comes through with a solid vault. That's a blind landing and so tough to stick.
And the judges scored a 9.75 for Crystal Cook from Austin, Texas. The Gymbacks will be up on bars first.
And Arkansas will lead with their experienced senior, Cassie Drew, and their top swingers, Emily Peacock, who set a school record on bars last year with a 9.95.
And the English major will be up first from Raleigh, North Carolina, Cassie Drew.
Cassie mounts with a dynamic release move from the low bar up to the high bar. Called a toe on Shaposhnikova, not a problem. Working into some combinations here. Giant half, front giant half, right into a release element to Kachev. Nice job on hitting that handstand in the vertical position. A little shy on that one on the low bar. Gaining some momentum. Big dismount planned. It's a double layout. Hop on the landing. She gets the arms up into the salute very quickly, trying to hold on to every tenth that they can at this point.
Another look.
This is the mount, the toe on Shaposhnikova, one of my favorite elements on bars. It's explosive. You need to get a tremendous height and distance to get from that low bar to the high bar. And Cassie does a great job. Look at the score.
9.725 for Cassie Drew. Back to Kentucky, and senior Lucy Bergen scored 9.8 six times last year on vault.
Remember, Kentucky's under pressure because the first athlete fell, and Lucy sits down on a Yuchenko half front layout.
What happened there?
Big miss for this senior. They're depending on their senior athletes for experience. She's a little bit slow in her rotation. She needs to be a little bit more aggressive, getting the chest up and the toes under to create that rotation so that she can complete the one and a half, basically, rotations to her feet.
So Kentucky will be counting a fall in their first rotation. Don't go anywhere. More Gymbacks and Wildcats when we return. Welcome back to Memorial Coliseum in Lexington, Kentucky. Arkansas in the middle of their bar rotation. How about the coach, though, taking this team to the national championships in just its fourth season of existence? And that's just what Renee Cook did last year.
It was amazing. You know, last year ended up like a fairy tale. I was like, this could be made into a movie. You know, who starts a team and within 4 years gets to the national championships, and especially with the senior class that started the program? You know, I think that will always be the most special thing to me is those girls took a risk. They came to our program with nothing there. We didn't even have a building, and they ended up leaving, competing at the national championships. I mean, it gives you goosebumps to think about the excitement of that experience. And so it's just really been amazing.
What the co-head coaches, Mark and Renee Cook, have done for this program is unprecedented. And think of that amazing senior class. They took a risk on this program. They were led by Dana McQuillan, and after 4 years, with an upstart program, they take it to the national championships.
And this is junior Emily Peacock for the Razorbacks.
Emily's ranked 21st in the country on this event, and you'll see why. Beautiful swing into that Jaeger. She has been so consistent for them this year.
She was voted the most consistent Gymback as a freshman.
So far, an aggressive routine. Just the dismount coming up. Gaining speed, looks like a double layout, nails the landing. Emily just stepped it up a notch for Arkansas. This is crucial to have perfect timing. A full turn on one arm, regrasp right into the Jaeger Salto. She looked almost a little bit close on the Jaeger, but she continues her momentum into the swing out of it. Nice job.
A 9.875. Now we move to Kentucky, and it's 4'11 sophomore Heather Height won the Catsby for the UK Female Rookie Athlete of the Year last season.
And look at Coach Mo behind her. He is giving her those eyes, almost willing her to nail this vault. They need a big one now. Yurchenko full, steps on the landing, but it's on her feet, and that's what Kentucky needs now. You see a little bit of a leg separation right there as she initiates the twist. There'll be a deduction and a small deduction for the step on the landing. But again, a solid vault that's on her feet.
You see the score, 9.725. And here are the scores for Kentucky on vault. Emily Reimer and Crystal Cook led the way for the Wildcats.
Still not that consistent performance that Kentucky wants right now. They did have to count a fall.
Here's the freshman, Casey Jo McGee, on bars.
She's the 2006 Oregon State bar champion. Release element, it's called a delchive, a little bit close there. She had to catch with bent arms, but she continues her swing. Giant full and a half on the high bar, into her straddle back to handstand on the low bar. Nice connection there. A little short on that final handstand. It's so difficult at the end of the bar routine when your arms are exhausted and the dismount. Back in, full out, steps on the landing. Solid routine.
There will be a deduction for the step back.
And a small deduction for catching the release element close. It's called a delchive. Comes from a backward swing, half turn into a front salto. You can see her elbows bend as she catches there. It's not often seen these days in collegiate gymnastics. Possibly a little more intricate to teach.
You see the score for Casey Jo McGee, and here are the scores for all of the Arkansas athletes on bars.
Arkansas did a nice job hitting 6 for 6. That's the consistency this team was looking for. Emily Peacock's crisp routine and nailed landing was a highlight.
Mistakes have hurt the home team. Can the Wildcats respond? We'll find out in a moment. Back to Memorial Coliseum. We're headed for the second rotation, and Kentucky keeping their focus. They're down in this meet to Arkansas, but they're keeping their poise, keeping their energy level up, trying to laugh a little bit. They know they're still in the meet. Here's the lineup, though, for Arkansas on vault.
They're ranked 12th nationally on this event, and Coach Renee Cook told me this was their most improved event. Freshman Michelle Stout set a school record with a 9.95 earlier this season.
And here's the freshman for Arkansas, Casey Jo McGee.
Yurchenko, half front layout, and nails the landing. An outstanding job. Technique and great air awareness is so important on this style of vault. It's a blind forward landing. Casey does not get her eyes on the mat before the feet hit it, and that's what makes it so difficult to stick it.
A 9.850 for the freshman from Eugene, Oregon. Here's the lineup for Kentucky on bars.
Earlier this season, Kentucky lost one of their best bar workers in Natalie Rubenstein. She tore her ACL, so once again, the Wildcats are leaning on their very talented but inexperienced freshman. There are four competing in this lineup.
And here is a freshman, Emily Reimer. The Wildcats coming off their season high against Florida, giving Emily and her team a lot of confidence.
I think we just went in there trying, each meet, we just tried to improve our score and not necessarily focus on beating the other team, and if we get our higher score, then we can beat the other team. So it's more of, you know, just worrying about ourselves right now.
Emily's meet ritual, Lori: listen to music and visualize my routines. Obviously, she and her team did it well last time out.
You can see her getting wound up before this routine, and a big miss to start. Oh my goodness, that is one of those misses that right now, it certainly hurts a gymnast's ego, but in a few weeks, that'll be something that they will look back on and have a little bit of a giggle.
Now, how often do you see something like that happen, Lori?
I would have to say that this is a fluke. You don't often see an athlete miss on somewhat of a basic mount like that. Emily is a freshman. She could have been a little bit anxious, a little bit wound up before this routine, and simply her hand slipped, and it does happen. That's a mandatory 5/10 deduction, and so important for Emily to come back strong now, because in the end, this may be a counting score for Kentucky.
You almost like to see her respond with a great effort here and a great landing.
Just a step on the landing, but the second half of this routine was outstanding.
Nice to see a good response and a good recovery for the freshman.
definitely a possibility. Nerves played a role, but I would just say it's a fluke. Did you take a look at her left hand when she went to plant it on the bar to give her some repulsion up over the bar? It slipped. She caught her fingertips, and the hand simply slipped.
Some words of encouragement from her teammates as we move on to the gym backs and Samantha Cortez, who was a member of the National Honor Society in high school.
Samantha is so talented on this event. She holds several of the top scores for Arkansas. Arkansas already has a nailed vault, and Samantha nails her Yurchenko full. Another outstanding effort. No steps on this landing. That means no deduction. The vault is scored out of a 10. Nice position in the air. Slight pike at the hips on the landing. Small deduction there. But this should be a strong high score.
The judges scored a 9.875 for Samantha Cortez. We move to another freshman, this time for the Wildcats. Freshman Emily Green played some lacrosse in high school, but here she's on bars.
Toe on hecked up to the high bar. Gaining some momentum, swing into her uprise half. She was a little short on that and short on the Jaeger. Ooh. Too far from the bar. Simply cannot regrasp. Being helped back up to the high bar, she must begin this routine from the point where the fall occurred. Again, 5-10 deduction. This is certainly hurting Kentucky. Elbows buckle on her shoot over. Short on her last handstand. Giant full double tuck, takes a step on the landing. Simply disappointed after the Jaeger. You could see it throughout the rest of the routine. She did not come back strong. Here she leads with her hips rather than kicking her heels up into the Jaeger, and that puts her too far from the bar to regrasp.
So a fall by Reimer, a fall by Green. What can Crystal Cook do about it for the home team Wildcats? We'll find out next. Welcome back. The Gymcats having a rough go of it in the second rotation against the Gymbacks here in Lexington. Can they respond? Well, they can rely on their go-to girl, Crystal Cook, who's ready for her bar routine.
Her teammates call her Cookie. They are cheering her on, hoping that Crystal can get things back on track for this Kentucky team. She has scored 9-9 on this event twice in the last 3 weeks. Certainly capable of it. Giant half, front giant half. Tkachev, nice height and distance. Straddle back to handstand. Toe on circle. Wants to hit this handstand there. Nice job. Now looking for a solid landing to get the big score. She nails it. That's the way Crystal Cook continues to do it, with consistency.
And
experience.
Just what the Wildcats needed, Lori.
Absolutely. There's that release element. 2 to 3 feet above the high bar. Beautiful extension and swing out of it.
And there it is, a 9.825. She seems a bit disappointed. Seemed like she thought she had a better score there. Here's Michelle Stout, who set a new school record on vault for the Gymbacks.
Performing the Yurchenko full. Big hop back on the landing and a step. Not quite the landing she would have needed to repeat that 9.95 she scored earlier this season. But you can see the potential in this vault. She's explosive. Nice push off the horse, pretty good stretch position in the air, slight pike in the hips on the landing, and of course the deduction for the hop and the step.
There it is, 9.725 for the former Junior Olympic National Vaulting Champion. Here's the Arkansas scores on vault.
And another 6 hits for this Arkansas team, and take a look at the scores. Pretty strong, all above the 9.7 mark.
Here's the senior, Lucy Bergen, for the home team on bars. Crystal got him started off well. Can Lucy follow that performance?
This will be her final performance in front of the home crowd. Big combination here. Giant half, Healy piked Jaeger. That's an E-level release element. She does an automatic shoot over the low bar. She reached her career high on this event this year, her senior year, with a 9.875 versus LSU. Takes a big step out on that landing. Maybe a little shy of that score here.
One more look at the landing.
giant half into the dismount. It's a double front. She does a nice job of taking this well above the high bar, but she simply hangs onto her knees too long in the rotation and over rotates it. It's another blind landing, very tough to stick.
Pretty good routine. It ends up a 9.775, so good for Lucy Bergen following that performance by Crystal. And Kentucky's overall scores on bars look like this.
Still a few bumps in the road for this young Kentucky team. Two falls, one of them will count that 9.175, but the two seniors are celebrating their final night in style.
Arkansas widens its lead, rotation three after this. So many future gymnasts in the audience here at Memorial Coliseum in Lexington, Kentucky. Kentucky looking forward to the future of their young program. And right now, they've got their work cut out for them. Corey Kessler and Lori Strong-Ballard ready for the third rotation. Here's Kentucky on beam.
And it's important that Kentucky put the mistakes of the first two events behind them. They need tremendous focus for the balance beam. And it's great to see Heather Height back competing for them. There's a great comeback story behind that athlete.
But first, a look at Crystal Cook. You saw her season high on beam.
Risky mount, opens with a front tuck, and solid as a rock. It feels so good to start off a routine that solid with huge difficulty. Split jump with a full turn. Required element is a full turn. Not a problem. Showing her tumble series back, handspring, layout, landing with 2 feet, slight bobble.
Last year's best all-arounder for the Gymcats.
Coach Mo told me that much of her performance comes down to her being confident and that they've had to work on that a little bit this year, but once she starts to feel confident in what she's doing, look out, she can be on fire. Switch leap, straddle jump, and another straddle jump. She's gaining bonus points by connecting those leaps, and the judges want to see the 180-degree split. And the dismount, punch front, layout full, sticks the landing. Another great routine for Crystal Cook. What a great senior night she's celebrating. Competing for the last time in front of this home crowd, she nails that very difficult front mount. That started this routine off on the right foot and built some confidence.
And just what the Wildcats needed in this third rotation. Here's the Arkansas lineup on floor. There you see the junior, Samantha Cortez.
So far, Arkansas is meeting their goal of consistency. They have not had to count a single fall tonight. On floor, their difficulty is moderate, but they are always entertaining and clean.
This is Rachel Barnett, trained at Bart Connor Gymnastics. Her father was a collegiate power lifting champion.
And certainly a lot of tradition behind that name, Bart Connor.
Of course.
An Olympic medalist. Opening with a whip to an immediate double pike and a big finish. Showing off some original dance and style. This is Rachel's first event tonight, and that can be difficult to sit out in the first two rotations and then get back into the competition both mentally and physically. Front full to a front tuck, stays in bounds. This is an event that Rachel loves to perform on and show off her style. It's her best event. She holds the record for Arkansas with a 9.95. Final tumbling pass, taking a deep breath, trying to get oxygen to those muscles. It's a difficult one, a double pike. Almost steps out of bounds. A dramatic, strong finish. Excellent routine. Arkansas continuing to show that consistency they've been looking for.
So when Kentucky has a good performance, Arkansas right there to respond. One more look.
At the opening pass, it's important to turn over that whip salto into the double pike. If it's slow or under-rotated, she could have a crucial landing on the double pike.
Meanwhile, here's Emily Reimer.
Emily had that fluky crash on her bar mount, and I'm sure that coaches Mo Mitchell and the beam coach Jackie McCarter are very interested to see how their young freshman will respond and rebound from that mistake. Tersia Tay Half. Trying to stay focused as she heads into her tumble series. Two back handsprings, layout, finds the landing, small wobble. Required full turn, no wobble there. Changement, tuck full. She's lacking a little bit of amplitude in some of her jumps. Sometimes that can come with being nervous and lack of experience.
That was quite a fall she had on bars.
She's responding very nicely here. So far, so good. Front aerial.
The final home meet for the Wildcats.
And the dismount, a gainer pike from the end. She finds the landing. She stays on the beam. Great comeback for this young freshman.
You have to feel good for Emily.
Here's the Tersia Tay Half, a very complicated and difficult leap because it requires split, a turn, a 2-foot landing, and a switch of the legs.
And a 9.8 to boot. Well done for Emily Reimer for the home team Wildcats. Cassie Drew is up next on floor. Hello to you as well. Welcome back to Memorial Coliseum in Lexington, Kentucky. We're in the middle of rotation three between the Gymbacks and the home team Wildcats. This is visitor Cassie Drew from Arkansas.
Cassie told me she's been working hard to get back into this floor lineup, but last week she won the floor title against powerhouse Alabama. Talk about proving yourself and making a strong point.
Especially against a team like Alabama, ranked so high year in and year out.
Opening with a double pike. Cassie's difficulty is not huge, but she does a nice job of working on those clean landings and showing off her personality and style in the dance. Front handspring, front layout. Again, clean in the air. That's a signature Cassie Drew move. I've seen it in her routine year after year. Arkansas as a whole has done a great job of mixing up their music choices and putting together entertaining routines. They kind of step out of the box in terms of their choreography sometimes.
Was on two undefeated teams in high school, her freshman and sophomore seasons.
Final pass, a double back, a little unstable on the landing, but she puts the smile on her face. Tries to cover up any possible deductions. And that's what being an experienced senior is all about. You know how to get the most out of your score. It's performance, it's the landings, it's making it happen, getting it done. Cassie does a great job here.
Her posture seemed excellent throughout the routine. Let's see how the judges score it, Lori.
First tumbling pass was not huge difficulty. She's not doing those E-level skills that will help her get the high nine nines. But it's a clean, difficult D-level skill, a double pike and a nice landing.
9.75. Here's Heather Height. Her season high beam score, you see, a 9.875. Wildcats could use a good performance right here.
She says one of the highlights of her career is scoring a 9.9 on this event, her very first meet as a collegiate gymnast. Complicated tumble series here, showing a forward element, front aerial, takes a slight pause, back handspring, layout, and solid. Kentucky's actually a little surprised and pleased to have Heather competing at all. In the fall, she had surgery to remove an extra bone in her knee. It was a surgery that's rarely performed. They weren't sure what the recovery time nor what the pain involved would be.
Feel sorry for those who come down with the same type of situation in the future, because she could lay the standard in a quick comeback.
Oh, she set the bar high in terms of comebacks, and Mo Mitchell, their head coach, told me that she was so determined to come back. pushed through rehab and has fought hard and is doing a great job for Kentucky tonight. And another solid routine for Heather Height. Outstanding. Things may be turning around for the Wildcats. Take a look at the tumble series. Front layout, beautiful technique there. She does take a slight pause, but that is no deduction. She's solid, no wobbles here, back handspring layout. Great job.
The judges scored a 9.850. Good score for Heather Height. Not quite her best, a 9.9, but good enough to lead her team.
And that leads her team to a season high on balance beam. That 9.85 means they can drop the 9.25. That's a record.
And that helps them get back into this meet, just what they needed in the third rotation. Here's the freshman from Arkansas, Michelle Stout.
And Michelle has recently really started to come into her own as a top all-arounder. She was second in the all-around against number one Florida. And as she prepares for her third rotation, Michelle finds herself in the mix in the all-around tonight as well. Round off by handspring, double pike, beautiful height.
Got some rhythm to the routine.
It's usually something that the coaches have to work on, especially with the freshman athletes, is their presentation. It's a little bit more showy than what you'd see, say, in club gymnastics. Front full, front pike. As a gymnast in practice, you may do one or two full floor routines, that means with the tumbling, and then you may go back and actually do dance throughs where you're just focusing on the dance, the leaps and the jumps, and the performance factor. Again, Arkansas has not counted a fall tonight. They have been solid and consistent. Looking for a nailed final tumbling pass here for Michelle Stout, just a freshman, finishing with a double back, a big smile, and a great routine.
So Arkansas responding after quite the effort by Kentucky. Here's another look at the final pass.
Again, we talked about Arkansas doing a good job of being clean, clean on their landings, their leaps and their jumps, entertaining in and throughout their dance. But they don't have those huge skills that will get them the 9.9, so a 9.825 is a very good, solid score.
And it leads the way for the Gymbacks.
They would like to be scoring over a 49 on floor, ideally, and that would mean a 9.8 average. A few landing errors kept them from that goal.
Kentucky smiles after a pretty good third rotation. They're still trailing. We have one rotation left. Crystal Cook and her Kentucky Wildcats need to close the gap with Arkansas. Welcome back to you folks. Memorial Coliseum here in Lexington, Kentucky. The lineup for Arkansas on beam looks like this.
And the highlight in this lineup comes from Emily Peacock. She has nice style and a huge dismount planned here, but you can see Cassie Drew is their leadoff, a senior, and she could be the key to their success. They need a consistent performance.
Renee's been putting me first up on beam, which is a little bit more pressure for me because I'm not used to being first. Had my first fall of the year last week, but I definitely have more confidence on beam now. We've been working a lot with our showmanship rather than just doing a routine to make it. We've been working on, you know, doing routines and making them look great and really showing it off.
And that's the point of the second half of the season. At this time of the year, it's not just about hitting and staying on. It's about hitting to maximize the score, and that means performance, no wobbles, and stuck landings.
Second half of the season and final rotation here in Lexington.
Dancing on the landing, but she holds on. 1/10 deduction versus a 5/10 deduction had she taken the fall. Straddle jump to a one-arm back handspring. You can see Cassie talking to herself. Many times the athletes use key phrases and words before each of their major elements. That was a switch leap to a straddle jump. Helps reinforce what the coaches have been telling them over and over again in practice. When her forward tumbling element, the athletes must perform both backward and forward tumbling.
Arkansas leading on the road here in the final rotation.
Leadoff performance is important in terms of building the scores, plus for building confidence for your teammates. When you look up and see an athlete hit a routine like this first up, it means so much to the team. Cassie's tumble series was quite difficult and intricate. Take a look. Back handspring. This second back handspring is done on one arm. That increases the difficulty into the layout. She takes a 1 to 2 tenth deduction on the wobble, but much better than taking the fall for 5 tenths.
So a 9.825 for Cassie Drew. She was first on beam. While Kentucky needs to respond on floor, here's the lineup.
Kentucky will feed off their success from beam and the energy from this home crowd. Crystal Cook anchors this lineup in her final senior night performance here at Memorial Coliseum.
And here's the freshman, Emily Reimer, on the floor exercise for the Gym Cats. Says the thing she would like to accomplish most as a gymnast is to make it to the NCAAs as a team.
If you ask any one of these athletes here, both on Kentucky and Arkansas's team, I would believe that that is their number one goal. They want to compete as a full team at the national championships. Now, Emily has scored as high as a 9.85 on this event this year, but she's also dealt with some consistency problems. Three tumbling passes in the routine. She needs to hit each and every one of them. Front full to a front layout. Great job.
Remember, this team trying to become the first Kentucky team to beat Arkansas in a gymnastics meet.
And if they do qualify to the national championships, they would be the first Kentucky team to ever make it to a nationals as well.
Be a dream come true for Emily Reimer if that were to happen.
Final tumbling pass. Front layout with a 1.5 twist. No problem hitting tonight on the floor exercise. Great job for a freshman, Emily Reimer. Final run is a front tumbling pass, a front 1.5. It's also called a Rudy. A little bit of a leg separation or cross in the air, but this should be a solid score, a 9.8.
Can't complain with that. Emily Reimer on floor. Kentucky needs a good score here in the final rotation. This is junior Emily Peacock for the Razorbacks.
And somehow Emily makes this nerve-wracking event seem enjoyable. Lunging out of her full turn to avoid the wobble. Preparing for her tumble series here. Taking time to concentrate. Back handspring, layout. Just a slight wobble.
Extreme focus in gymnastics as well as in the classroom. A 3.79 GPA as a freshman.
You know, I've talked to many of the coaches, and they often say that success in the classroom correlates to success in the gym as well. When the athletes are focused and dedicated to their studies, it often rubs off with their dedication in the gym as well.
We'll see what kind of mark she gets after her beam routine here.
You can hear her teammates cheering her on from the sidelines into her big dismount. It's a difficult one. A round off double back, and she nails the landing. Look at the discipline on the position in her landing. An excellent job. And here's the tumble series. Three elements directly connected. The athletes are only required to do two. She ups the difficulty a little bit. The front foot comes off the beam slightly for a 1/10 wobble.
9.875 for Emily Peacock. We're not done yet. Final routines in just a moment. You talk about floor exercise. Go get them, little fella. Welcome back to Memorial Coliseum. Here's Heather Height, who says to her young athletes, always work hard in school. Remember to enjoy and appreciate the sport.
athlete has so much heart, so dedicated, and such a hard worker in the gym, and that is paying off on the competition floor as well. She missed her first two meets of the season on floor, but has competed everyone since then, opening with a double pike and a solid landing. I am so impressed at how strong she has come back from that knee surgery. Heather does a nice job of paying attention to the details, the simple things like making sure the toes are pointed in some of this floor work. Hitting every position in the dance, it's crisp, it's clean, and it's a pleasure to watch.
And the music is different. It's more of a Tchaikovsky-esque type.
It's very dramatic. She's playing off that as well. A little bounce out on the double back. I'd like to see teams show different types of music amongst their athletes. It really makes it a little more exciting for the viewer as well as the judges. And of course, you have to play off the athlete's personality. Oh, a little struggle there, a front full to a front tuck. It almost looked like her knees buckled into the final element, the front tuck. Obviously, she is disappointed with this performance. It was so strong up until that final tumbling pass. Let's take a look at what went wrong here. Front handspring, front full. Take a look right here. Her knees buckle just slightly. She gets a dead punch into that front tuck. There's not enough momentum, height, and rotation to put herself on her feet. 9-2-5. This is what Mo Mitchell keeps talking about, this Kentucky team. They have the potential and the skill level. They just need to hit or they can't get those scores.
Here's the 17th-ranked gymnast in the Southeastern Conference on beam, Casey Jo McGee.
Different tumbling pass right here. Round off, layout, step out. Tiny wobble, but holds on. Arkansas has suffered one fall on the balance beam so far. If Casey Jo can get a secure hit for them here, that will be 5 hits, which means they have not counted a fall the entire night. Most certainly a step in the right direction for this Arkansas team,
which has never lost to Kentucky.
And tonight they're looking for a solid road score to replace a weaker one they had earlier this season against Utah, where they had major travel problems and arrived at the competition just a few hours before it began. They had a weak performance that night, but tonight they have been so strong. This is their 5th hit, which means that Arkansas does not count a fall. Casey Jo showing some nice fight on the balance beam with that round off layout, slight wobble, but no fall.
And what that means, Casey Jo's performance solidifies a season best for Arkansas on beam with that 49.175. Well, now to Kentucky on floor once again, and Crystal Cook's final performance as a Kentucky Wildcat in this Memorial Coliseum.
A special moment in Crystal's career right here. She will try to enjoy every moment of it, playing up to her teammates, gaining some energy from this crowd. This is her final chance to show them what she's got. First tumbling pass, it's a sky-high double back. Crystal says her most memorable moment as a gymnast was winning the regional vault title, which then qualified her to the national championships last year. But this year, like everyone else on her team, she wants to qualify a full team to the national championships in Utah.
Of course, Kentucky goes on the road for a month straight after this meet. That's why it is the final home meet for Crystal Cook and her team.
Front handspring, front layout, front full, holds it in bounds. It's definitely an emotional time for an athlete to be competing in their senior night. Brings back a lot of memories from the past 4 years. It also means that your career as a gymnast is starting to come to an end. There's only a few more meets for Crystal Cook to compete in. These athletes don't have a professional league to move on to. This is their final stop in their gymnastics career. And a great performance for Crystal. On all four events tonight, this was just the finishing touch. That opening pass, sky high, double back. Her knees buckled just slightly on her final tumbling pass, but three solid tumbling passes on her feet and a 9.725.
Some emotional, heartwarming hugs for the senior Crystal Cook for her Wildcats. A 48.6 is the overall score for Kentucky. Crystal Cook will remember that performance on floor for the rest of her life, her final floor exercise and her final home meet for the Kentucky Wildcats, as Mo Mitchell gives some encouragement to his team. Wasn't enough tonight, but still a long way to go in the season and a very long way to go for the future of Kentucky gymnastics, a very young team. You see the final score, Arkansas gets the victory. Lori Strong Ballard is with the winners.
Thanks, Corey. Coaches, congratulations on a big win and your highest road score of the year. Renee, you mentioned that it wasn't just about the win here, that it was important for you guys to gain some consistency and get a high road score. Where does this rate in terms of meeting those goals?
I think it was great. You know, we didn't kind of fall. We scored well on the road, and this is definitely going to help us achieve our goals down the road.
And Mark, you have a very young team. How important is it to get a win like this in terms of building their confidence as you head into the second half of the season?
Well, it's huge. We've struggled a bit with that inconsistency with the younger team this year, but Deborah Class, we're trying to show them the way, and they're all finding the way to do it and get it done. But we gained a lot of confidence tonight, and it's really a good thing going into the next meet.
Well, congratulations and good luck with the rest of your season. Back to you, Corey.
So the visiting Arkansas Gymbacks get the job done, but Crystal Cook gets the job done as the all-around winner in her final home meet. Lori is with Crystal for more.
Well, Corey, how fitting is it that at senior night here at Memorial Coliseum, you, Crystal Cook, take home the all-around title? How was this experience tonight?
It was really a great night, and I'm just happy I was able to go out in front of my home crowd and give them a great show.
Was it a little bit emotional at the end when you did your final floor routine, the final performance in front of the home crowd?
Yeah, it really was, and I was just happy that I gave them a great performance and that they can go out remembering a good floor routine.
Well, congratulations to you for tonight and for four great years at Kentucky. Good luck as you hit the road with the rest of your season.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Crystal Cook, our all-around winner, and congratulations to the visiting Arkansas Gymbacks for winning the meet in the Southeastern Conference against the home team Kentucky Wildcats. Thanks to Lori Strong Ballard, I'm Corey Kessler. Thank you for watching us. We'll say so long from Memorial Coliseum.